All right. Welcome to KPN TV's coverage of Gloucester High School Hockey. I'm here with Coach Sean Lyons. And, Coach, you're coming off a tough loss Saturday night, but tonight you start back into conference play. You got some big games coming up for the rest of the season.
Yeah, you know, our back's against the wall with our current record. But like you said, we got the conference games. I got Lynn tonight, and we got to go from there. We got one loss in the conference already. So we got to right the ship right now.
Well, you may have caught in a break with the schedule because you've only played one conference game so far. The rest of your season is basically conference games.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, you know, that's for the most part is we got, you know, Damris and Linfield on the outside, but you know, I'd like to have a better record coming into all these conference games with a little bit of a cushion, but we're gonna do what we gotta do.
All right, Coach, good luck tonight, and we'll see you around the rink.
Thank you very much.
All right, we'll be back with Gloucester High School Hockey in just a few moments.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Ben's Wallpaper and Paint, you will experience a level of service you thought no longer existed. We're proud to deliver the kind of specialized attention that you thought no longer existed and simply won't find in larger chain stores. Whether from our full line of Benjamin Moore paint or custom window treatments, you will find what you need at Ben's Wallpaper and Paint at 6th Railroad Avenue here in Gloucester. Community is the key. That's why we support KPN Television, so they can deliver valuable, local, community-based news, sports, and information about KPN, which is so important to all of us.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPN TV. You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
KPN Auto Body and Service Center has served KPN families since 1955. We learned long ago that the best way to keep our customers is to provide skilled and friendly services at reasonable prices. Unlike large or chain repair businesses, each of our customers is a very important part of our business.
Personal is what makes KPN Television so valuable to our community. That's why we support KPN Television, so that they can deliver valuable community-based news, sports, and information about KPN, which is so important to us all.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPN TV.
Everybody, welcome back. KPN TV's coverage of Gloucester High School Hockey. I'm Phil Nicastro, Jim Capillo on the camera tonight. The Fishermen return home for a conference game against the Lynn Jets. Gloucester comes into this game with a 4-6 record. And the Fishermen are facing a couple of must-win situations the rest of the year to qualify for the States. But the good news is for Gloucester, they've only had one conference game all year long, and they still got their conference schedule ahead of them. And this is one game here tonight against the Lynn Jets. They have to play Lynn again later on this year. They're going to play Revere twice and Swampscott one more time, and that's their conference schedule. They can still win the Northeast Conference South to get the automatic bid for the state tournament, which means they're going to have to win just about all five games. They've already lost to Swampscott. And right now we're having the introduction of the players. So the Fishermen right now have their backs against the wall, and if they don't win the conference, they're going to have to get the required 20 points to qualify for the state tournament. And they need to get going. They only get 8 points in the year. A win tonight would go a long way for the Fishermen. And they're introducing the Gloucester team right now. We'll have our national anthem in just a few moments. The Northeast Conference South Division only has four teams in it. Salem could not put a team on the ice this year. Just not enough interest there. And we're getting ready for our national anthem right now. A nice rendition of our national anthem. We're almost ready for some hockey here tonight, and I'm going to have to say this is a must-win game for the Fishermen if they want to entertain any chances of getting into the state tournament. Sal Costanzo will be starting at center. He'll have E.J. Field. And Ethan Brennan, number 10, is out there. He's coming off a high ankle sprain. He missed a couple of games. On defense, Harrison Marshall. And number 21, Eric Chalmers, and we're almost ready to go. All right. And we're underway. Noah Polinski in goal for the Fishermen. The puck is in the Lynn zone, but the Fishermen can't convert. Chalmers gets it up to the neutral zone, and Sal Costanzo has it. He's got Brennan with him. E.J. Field goes in the corner after it. Field out front. Oh, the shot goes wide. So the Fishermen had a quick opportunity right there to start the game. And we got a big hit. Marshall took a big hit along the boards. And Field throws his weight around. Marshall flips into the neutral zone. Hopkins. Shot save. Jack Stafford, the goaltender for Lynn, the captain of the Lynn Jets. Lynn is a combination of Lynn English and Lynn Classical. And they call themselves the Lynn Jets. Liam Lyons out there. Puck goes in the corner. Hopkins goes after it. Good hustle by Derek Hopkins. Gets it out to the point to Polinski. Back down low to Hopkins again. The puck comes to the near side. Lyons over there forechecking. And Lynn gets it out. Sperry trying to keep it in, but he can't. And here comes Lynn with a 2-on-1. Shot. Save Polinski. So Lynn had a good chance there. And here comes the Fishermen. And they can't connect on a pass. Polinski with it. Makes a nice pass to Mitchell. Colby Mitchell out there, number 16 for the Fishermen. Chris Noyes, Colby Mitchell, and Lucas Cornetta out there to third line. Chalmers and Marshall on defense. Shots on goal. Gloucester has two. Lynn has one. Puck goes in the corner. Christopher Noyes is out there. Puck goes behind the net. Cornette is there, number 7 for the Fishermen. Mitchell and Cornette are in there forechecking. But Lynn comes out with it. Nice play by Mitchell. Back down to Cornette. He goes to the other side. Noyes over there. Chris Noyes out front. No one's there. Up front, back shot, save, rebound, save, Stafford. Jack Stafford, pretty good goaltender. There's some good goalies in this league this year. .1304 left, first period. Jim Capillo on the camera. KPN TV's coverage of Gloucester High School Hockey. Ethan Brennan, Costanzo's out there with E.J. Field. Gets it back out to the point to Marshall. And the shot is blocked. He gets run over, Marshall. And we got a penalty coming up on Lynn. I think we're going to have a charging. And better watch out. Okay, the Fishermen have it. Costanzo with it. The goaltender is out. We got a delayed penalty. Out front. Pass was in the air. Fishermen make control it. Chalmers over to Lyons. It's still a delayed penalty. The net is empty for Gloucester. They got the extra attacker out there. And Lynn touches up, and we got a penalty coming up on Lynn. And I think we're going to have a high stick. Number 4, John Cosmas is going to head to the penalty box for Lynn. A minute and a half for a high stick. And so Gloucester will get an early power play. Costanzo on the draw, wins the draw, gets it back to Polinski. He gets it down low to Lyons, back down low to Marshall. Marshall looks to be a forward on the power play. Polinski out front to Costanzo, shot, save, Stafford, a beauty. Jack Stafford of Lynn. Costanzo on the draw. Harrison Marshall is a forward. No, is that Harrison Marshall? Yes, it looks like him. Was it John Mondello? All right, looks like Mondello. Okay. All right. Puck was behind the net. Costanzo chases after it. Gains control. Gets it out to Sam Polinski. And Polinski can't keep it in. Eric Chalmers, number 21 for the Fishermen, goes after it. And they can't get it out. Chalmers, he gets it now. And the Fishermen can't make a connection. We're down to 34 seconds left on the power play. Lyons has the puck. And he passes it over to Polinski. Oh no, he gives it straight up. Turnover. Shot. Score! A shorthanded goal. For Lynn, number 2. Sean Devin of Lynn gives the Jets a 1-0 lead on a shorthanded goal, and the Fishermen sloppy in their own end. Off the draw. Lynn gains control. Not a good power play for the Fishermen. Sperry. They throw it back in. Goes off the boards. Sperry with it. Number 11. And the power play has come to an end. Cornette with the puck. Passes it over to Meniz. Gives it back to Cornette with a nice play. Cornette throws it in deep. Mitchell goes after it. Colby Mitchell. Over to Chris Noyes. Noyes keeps it in. He takes a hit but maintains possession. The Lynn Jets lead at 1-0 on a shorthanded goal. You hate to see that. So the Fishermen need the rebound. All right. They come to Jets. And they get it out of the zone. Nice hit by Meniz. Puck goes behind the net. Sperry with it. Jack Sperry makes a nice pass over to Christopher Noyes. Comes at the near boards. And here comes Lynn. And the fishermen try to get it out, but they can't. Another penalty coming up on Lynn. I think we're going to have a cross check on the Lynn team. And let's see. Number 15 for Lynn, John DeFilippo. So the fishermen will have their second power play of the night. But they trail at 1-0. They gave up a shorthanded goal in their last power play. Mondello, Costanzo, and Lyons are the three forwards. Chalmers is out there with Meniz on D. Here comes Lynn, though, again. No, make that Sperry. And the fishermen again can't get it out of their zone on the power play. Lynn, their penalty killing unit, is doing a great job. Sperry with the puck behind the zone net. 1 minute left on the Gloucester power play. Here comes the Lyons. He's got some skating room. Gets the blue line. Shot, save, Stratford. Up front, no one's there. Lynn has it. And here come the Lynn Jets, 2-1-2. 45 seconds left in the Gloucester power play. Fishermen can't handle the puck on their own end again. And here comes Costanzo. Gets through, makes a nice move. Out front, shot, score! Colby Mitchell ties the game up with an assist from Costanzo. A power play goal for the Fishermen, and they needed that big time. Colby Mitchell with an assist from Sal Costanzo. Power play goal for Gloucester. They tie it up at 1. 8:41 left, first period. And what a nice pass that was by Sal Costanzo. Liam Lyons, John Mondello, and Derek Hopkins are the forwards. Jake Enos is out there for Gloucester, number 14. Puck in the neutral zone. And here comes Lynn, 2-1-1. But John Mondello gets back, shot on goal, save Polinski. Liam Lyons. Over to Chalmers, back to Lyons. He makes a pass to the wing. Mondello has it, but it goes back in the zone. Chalmers throws it all the way back behind his own net to Jake Enos. Enos makes a nice pass. And the fishermen are going backwards. Lynn on a line change. Chalmers. And the fishermen all confused at their own blue line. Here comes Lynn again. 3-on-2. Shot, score! Number 7, Kevin Morgan of Lynn gives the Jets a 2-1 lead. So the Jets take the lead right back. On a goal by number 7, Kevin Morgan. 2-1 Lynn, 7:34 left first period. Lynn wins the draw. Sperry with it. Puck goes to the neutral zone, Polinski. And it goes over the glass. And I believe the faceoff will be right at center ice again. That's where the referee is pointing. Chris Noyes on the draw. Cornetta's out there with Mitchell. Perry. Can't do anything with it. And here comes Lynn again. Offsides. Chris Noyes has it. And it goes back in the zone. Fishman are not controlling the puck well so far in this game. Lynn keeps it in. And the puck's out front. Comes back out to the point. They keep it in. Shot. Deflected. Rebound. Save. Polinski. Score again. And Lynn takes a 3-1 lead. Number 14 for Lynn. Mike Clottery. And it's 3-1 Lynn, and the Fishermen have been very sloppy in their own end today so far in this game. So Costanzo's back out there with Ethan Brennan and E.J. Field. Puck goes in the corner. Costanzo over to Brennan. And the Fishermen having a hard time getting the puck out of their own end. Harrison Marshall behind his own net. Makes a pass. And the puck is out of the zone, but Lynn throws it right back in. Number 14, Mike Clardy. Clardy gives Lynn a 3-1 lead. Brennan. Ethan Brennan makes a nice pass to E.J. Field. Field's shot goes wide. Lynn gets the puck out. They have control in the neutral zone. And here comes Lynn again. Shot. Save Polinski. Nice save there. That was a shot by Brian Clottery. It was Mike Clottery who got the previous goal for Lynn. 3-1 Lynn. Face off in the Gloucester zone. Off the draw. Lynn has it in Gloucester's end. Puck comes out to the point. Shot. Save Polinski. That puck looked like it was going wide, but he made the save anyways. 5:34 left, first period. 3-1 Lynn. Face off in the Gloucester zone. Fishermen win the draw. They try to flip it out. Mitchell, number 16. Lions has it. Over to Chalmers. Back to Mitchell. No, excuse me, that's Lions. Lions goes in, hustles after it. Lions out front. Derek Hopkins in the corner. He's fighting for it. Lions goes in there. Puck's along the boards. Puck comes in the near side. Chalmers cracks down with a good hit. Lions has it. Makes a good move. He's got no one with him, though. He makes a nice move. He gets through. Shot goes high and wide. Mondello keeps it in. Yep. Mondello can't control it. And so Lynn has possession of the puck right now. Over to Chalmers has it. Over to Sperry. Nice pass, makes a pass to Chris Noyes, but they couldn't connect, and it goes all the way down the other end for a nice 4:20 left. First period, 3-1 Lynn. The shots on goal are even at 7 apiece, but the story of this game is Gloucester's inability to get the puck out of their own end. They got to clean that part of their game up. All right, off the draw. Goes in the corner. Meniz in there fighting for it. Sperry. Kept in by Lynn. Save Polinski. Rebound Polinski with another save. Oh, that was big there for Noah Polinski. Kept in by Lynn. Sperry banks it off the boards and he gets it out of the zone. Cornetta in there. He's fighting hard. Pucks up on the near boards. Christopher Noyes takes it out. Noyes peels back, gives it to Sperry. Makes a pass, but it's can't connect. Here comes Lynn again. Nice hit by Meniz. Lynn has control. EJ Field comes off the bench. Meniz throws it in deep. Field in there forechecking. Costanzo comes out with it. Got a man in front, can't get it to him. Gets it to the point to Sperry. Back down to Costanzo again. Costanzo back to Sperry, shot deflected wide. Sperry keeps it in. Costanzo with it out front. Costanzo takes it to the middle, shot save Stafford. Puck comes out of the zone. Sperry with it. 3-1 Lynn. 2:45 remaining in the first period. Lynn has it in the neutral zone. Meniz with it. Puck goes in the zone. Costanzo goes after it. He's in there forechecking. EJ Fields in there forechecking. But here comes Lynn. They have control. Ethan Brennan can't control it. Lions takes a hit. Kept in by Chalmers. He throws it to the wide corner. Mitchell's out front. Couldn't find anybody. And kept in by Hopkins. Nice pass. Oh, Mitchell couldn't control it. Polinski shot blocked. Nice play. Mitchell behind the net out front. And it's a goal! It's a goal! I believe that was Derek Hopkins, and he took a baseball swing at it and knocked it home. So with 1:43 left in the first period, the Fishmen make it a 3-2 game. And I do believe it was Derek Hopkins' goal as he knocked it out of midair. And they're making a 3-2 game. Off the draw. Hopkins, Mitchell along the boards. Mitchell hustling. Hopkins with the goal. Here comes Lynn again. 3-on-2. Shot blocked by Chalmers. Hopkins trying to get it out. He does. Mitchell is there. Passes it back over to Hopkins. He throws it in deep. The Fishermen get a line change. 1:10 remaining in the first period. Kept in by Chalmers. Takes a hit. Lions keeps it in. Try to make a pass, but it was intercepted. 1 minute left in the period. Sperry. And here comes Lynn again. And what do we got? We got a slash coming up. And who's going out? And I believe it's Lynn, yeah. Number 16 for Lynn. Ryan Craig is going to go to the penalty box for a slash. So the Fishermen will go on a power play with 52 seconds remaining in this period, and they trail it by one goal. Costanzo on the draw with Lions. And I believe that's Mitchell, the other forward. Yep, Colby Mitchell. Gets it to the point to Polinski. Back down low, but the pass was intercepted. Lynn clears it. Half a minute left in the period. Chalmers over to Polinski. Back over to Chalmers. And here come the Fishermen. They still got time in this period. Costanzo, he's in. Shot. Save Stafford. A nice pass by Mitchell to Costanzo. But Jack Stafford, the captain for the Lynn team, made a nice save. 16 seconds left in the period. 54 seconds left on the power play. Back to the draw. Score! Eric! Yarmuth ties it up, and I don't think Stafford saw that. He never saw that coming. I think he was screened, and by the time the player moved out of the way, the puck was by him. So the Fishermen tie it on a power play goal with 13 seconds remaining in the period. Eric Chalmers off the draw, Meniz. He has the puck, makes a pass to Lyons. 5 seconds left in the period, and that will do it in the first period. All right, after one period with the score, Gloucester 3, Lynn 3. We'll be right back after these messages.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
When you walk into either of our branches, you'll experience a local bank feel with big bank returns. We are proud to support many community organizations, nonprofits, and events, both financially and by employees volunteering their time. That's why we support KPN Television, so that with the help of their volunteers, they can deliver valuable community-based news, sports, and information about KPN, which is so important to us all.
Join, volunteer, support. Local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPAN TV. You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
We take pride in our ability to anticipate and adapt to the ever-changing terrain of the commercial printing industry. Since our founding in 1922, the Cricket Press, along with our weekly newspaper, the Manchester Cricket, have long valued the importance of local news and information. That is why we support KPN Television, so they can continue to provide community television programming for the KPN area.
Join, volunteer, support. Local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPAN TV.
Daddy, that light's on again. I think we need to go to Extreme Truck and Auto and Cheese Shop.
When this happens to you, there's no need to go to a dealer, whether you're a foreign or a domestic car. We can take care of that right here at Extreme. We have a complete line of Snap-on diagnostics specifically made for all your vehicle needs. Bumper to bumper, foreign or domestic, we can take care of it all here at Extreme. Here at Extreme, we guarantee all of our work for you.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Scott Energy, we have built our business one customer at a time with a hands-on, personal approach. In the process, we have gained customers in our communities who have come to appreciate our attention to value and quality service. We truly appreciate your business, and in turn, have made it our policy to give back to the communities that we serve. That's why we support KPN Television, so that they can deliver valuable, community-based news and information about KPN, which is important to all of us.
Join, volunteer, support. Local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPAN TV.
All right, I'm here with Nick Kukuru at the end of the first period. Nick, that period, Gloucester kind of struggled in their own end.
They did. They probably had more sustained pressure as a whole for the period, but they took better care of the puck and across Gloucester at least one goal. I'd say two.
Yeah.
Two goals. So.
Give the team credit. They fought back to tie this game. They got to clean up their game in their own end.
Yeah, absolutely. And hopefully that's something that sparks them, because they've been struggling to put the puck in the net consistently. And, you know, maybe that little outburst there at the end of the period is what they need, because, you know, they have firepower. They just haven't put it together completely.
They're coming off a tough loss Saturday night at Winthrop. But the good news is, I think, anyways, is that they got all their conference games still ahead of them. Did the schedule make it give them a break, you think?
A little bit. They have a couple tough out-of-conference games, finishing up with Winfield. Swampscott looks like, though, they'll probably be the favorite when they play on Monday. Swampscott beat Danvers. Swampscott beat two of the top NEC Lodge teams. So that win over Gloucester's looking like no fluke.
But the Fishermen are going to have to get on a roll if they expect to qualify.
Absolutely. They can only afford, two more losses the rest of the way. So they've got to go on a run.
Yeah. All right, Nick. We'll see you around.
Definitely.
All right, we'll be back with Gloucester High School hockey for the second period action in a few moments.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
Here at the Fitness Zone, we are proud to serve the community that we have been a part of for over 18 years. Here you will find a huge selection of equipment, fitness classes, personal trainers, and a juice bar. We are located at 37 Blackburn Center, right next door to Cape Ann TV. Community is the key. That's why we support Cape Ann Television, so they can deliver valuable, local, and community-based news and sports from Cape Ann, which is so important to all of us.
Join. Volunteer. Support. Local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPAN TV.
All right, everybody, welcome back. Second period action. 3-3. Shots on goal, 11 for Gloucester, 9 for the Jets. Fishermen fell behind early, 3-1, but to their credit, they fought back to tie the game with 2 power play goals. They gave up a shorthanded goal. But 3-3 going into the second period. And number 16 for Lynn is going back in the penalty box. I think he caught a misconduct on that slash. They gave him a minor penalty plus a misconduct, so he's still sitting in the penalty box. And we're almost ready for second period action. Sal Costanzo out there. E.J. Field. Sam Polinski. And Ethan Brennan, number 10. Ethan's coming back from a high ankle sprain. That's a tough injury to deal with. But he's back in the lineup tonight. All right. Fishermen need this win big time. All right, Sal Costanzo on the draw. All right, second period action underway. Lynn has control. They bank it off the boards. Puck's kept in by the Jets. Puck goes in deep behind the Gloucester net. Lynn has control out to the point with a nice pass. Shot. Goes wide. Puck goes back behind the Gloucester net. Sperry's there. Polinski. E.J. Field tried to get out. He does. They make a good pass. Costanzo, but he got broken up offsides. Sal Costanzo had gone in over the blue line, and E.J. Field took the puck back over the blue line, and that's offsides. Number 16 from Lynn has now come out of the penalty box. Ryan Craig, so it was not a misconduct. He has to wait for the next stoppage of play to come out. And the end of a period does not count as a stoppage of play. All right. Chom is with it. Eric Chom. Shot. High and wide. Kept in? No, it's not kept in. And here comes Lynn. Oh, they almost had a breakaway. Hopkins gets it back to the Marshall over to Chalmers. He takes a hit. And Colby Mitchell gets it out. Derek Hopkins after it. Goes behind the net. Liam Lyons is hustling after it. Comes along the near boards. Lynn controls it. They keep it in. Nice job by Marshall keeping that in. Lyons gets it back to the point to Chalmers, and he fanned on his shot, and Lynn controls it. Here they come, 3-on-2. They throw it in deep. Goes behind the Gloucester net. Liam Lyons steals it with a nice play. Liam makes a nice pass to John Mondello, but he can't control it. Chalmers with it. Behind the net to Harrison Marshall. Up to John Mondello. Mondello gets it over to Chalmers. And the fisherman can't penetrate. And here comes Lynn. And they fall. They fin on the shot. It was a 2-on-1. And Eric Chalmers went flying into the net. That may have been the best thing. That was a scoring opportunity for Lynn right there. Faceoff will be in the Gloucester zone. Chris Noyes, Cornetta. Out there. Mondello. And he finds Cornetta. Cornetta's in all alone. Score! No, it's off the post. They didn't count it. It hit the inside of the post. And that one looked like it may have been gone in, but I don't know. I don't think they're going to call that one. Cornetta again. Wow, the fisherman came that close to taking the lead. And here comes Lynn. Puck goes behind the Gloucester net. Sam Polinski with it. John Mondello, number 5. Flips it up along the boards. Here comes Chris Noyes. Makes a nice stop. Shot wide. And Lynn comes out with it. And Sam Polinski ties it up. Excuse me, Noah Polinski, Sam's his brother. 12:04 left, second period. 3-3 tie, and Lucas Cornetta came within a half an inch of giving the fisherman the lead. Face off in the Gloucester end. Here comes Sal Costanzo for the draw. Ethan Brennan's out there with him. With EJ Field, Sperry, and Sam Polinski on D. Lynn wins the draw. They get it back to the point. Shot. It's deflected. And here comes Sam Polinski. And Gloucester's got numbers. And it's offsides. Oh, the fisherman had a break, and EJ Field couldn't keep his foot on the other side of the blue line. And we have an offsides. Come on, 11:52 left, second period. Polinski. Sperry back to Polinski. Polinski taps it in the zone. Brennan on the far side, he can't control it. And here comes Lynn. Puck goes behind the net. Sam Polinski. And here comes Gloucester. And they couldn't get it to him, but they maintain possession. Oh, Costanzo was broken up at the last minute. And that looked like an opportunity gone by the wayside for Gloucester. And the puck's behind the net. The fisherman got to get it out of there. EJ Field working hard along the boards. Costanzo trying to get it out. They can't. Lynn controls it. out front. A good play by Eric Chalmers there. And the fishermen clear it. No ice. Chalmers. It goes behind the Gloucester net. Harrison Marshall there makes a nice play. Takes the puck right away. Brings it back on the near side where Derek Hopkins is. And he loses control. Lions can't control it.
Let's go! Come on!
And it goes all the way back in on Noah Polinsky. Chalmers with it. Gets it up to the near boards. Shot is blocked. But Lynn keeps it in. Out front. No one's there for him. Colby Mitchell on the far side. Gets it back down to Harrison. But Mitchell gets it out. And Lions hustling after it. And that's an ice. Yep, Lynn ices the puck. So the faceoff will come all the way back down into the Lynn zone. And Gloss has had a couple of opportunities this period to take the lead. Most notably, Lucas Cornetta hit the inside of the post. Chris Noyes on the draw. Cornetta's back out there with him. John Mondello looks to be the other forward on this line. Sperry with it. And John Mondello makes a nice play. He's hustling all the time. And the puck goes all the way down to Gloucester's end. And it's another icing. 9:17 left, second period. The score is still tied at 3. And a very important Northeast Conference South game. Gloucester needs this victory big time. Costanzo, Field, and Brennan is the line. Puck comes to the near boards. Shot by Field. Deflected wide. Costanzo hustling after it. Here comes Lynn. Marshall. It's tipped in by Field. Goes all the way behind the Lynn net. On the far boards. Kept in by Chalmers. Deflected in. Saved by Stafford. Ethan Brennan, nice hustle there. Gets it out front. Costanzo's there. Can't do anything with it. Goes back behind the Lynn net. Costanzo tried to get it out front to Brennan, but it was intercepted. Brennan along the boards. And here comes Lynn. 3-on-2. Back out front. And good defense by Chalmers. Colby Mitchell gets it out of there. Lynn knocks it back in. They're offsides, but they got a touch up. And it's an ice. Okay, they called an icing. With 8:07 remaining in the second period. Fishermen come into this game with a 4-6 record. Lions on the draw. Out there with Hopkins and Colby Mitchell. Get it back to Polinsky. Lions can't control it. Kept in by Sperry, but Lynn gets it right back out. And here come the Jets. Shot. Save Polinsky. It goes behind the net. And the fishermen get it out of there. But Lynn keeps it in. Sam Polinsky with a nice hit. Up to Hopkins. Good pass over to Colby Mitchell. Here comes Liam Lyons. He could be in all alone. Shot. Save Stafford. Colby Mitchell. He saw Lyons screaming up the middle of the ice. He gets in the puck. Lyons went in all alone. Shot. Save Stafford. Gloucester has definitely had the better opportunities in this period. Shots on goal. 14-10. Fishermen score tied at 3. 7:36 left. Second period. Lyons loses the draw. Harrison Macho pinches down with a nice play. Oh, and the fishermen lose control of the puck. Lynn now has it. Here come the Jets. Puck goes behind the fisherman net. Nice play. And they can't get the other door. Now they get it out. Harrison Marshall throws it back in. And they're going to call it an icing? Ooh. It looked like he was right on the red line. But the referee didn't seem to think so. Face off in the Gloucester end. Score tied at 3. Lynn, they committed this game with a 6-2-1 record. But they've only had one conference game as well. So both of these teams need this victory. And Lynn breaks up the play. Goes behind the net. Chalmers over to Cornetta. Back to the point, blocked. Nice play, Chris Noyes. He hustles after it. Breaks it up. Mondello keeps it in. Cornetta throws it behind the net. Chris Noyes goes over there. Makes a nice hit. Chalmers shot. Save Stafford. Right up, 6-10 remaining. Second period. Fishermen bring out their first line again. Costanzo, Brennan, and Fields. Kept in. Nice play at the point, but they can't control it. Lynn has control on their own end. Puck goes behind the Gloucester net. Lynn goes in and forechecks. They're there first, but the fishermen come out with it. Field along the boards. And Costanzo with it. He's got some speed. Gains the blue line. Looking for someone to pass to. He finds Brennan. Shot saves. Rapid. And Brennan went over after his own rebound. And I guess that irritated a couple Lynn players. So we do have a penalty. We got a slash coming up on Ethan Brennan. Oh, boy. Now the faceoff will go down in the Gloucester zone. So Lynn will go on the power play. Ethan Brennan took a shot. The goaltender Stafford made the save with his glove, and Brennan went in and gave him a little hack. But the referee's calling it. All right. 5:32 left, second period. Lynn will go on a power play. Face off in the Gloucester end. Chalmers wings it around and gets it out of there. EJ Field hustles after it. Lynn on the power play. Here they come. Chalmers knocks it into the corner. Lynn trying to set their power play up. They do now. Shot. Save Polinski. Puck is in the corner. The fisherman trying to get it out. Chalmers tries to whack it around, but he can't get it out. Shot. Save Polinski. Puck is still in the Gloucester end. And nice hustle there by Chalmers. Here comes Chalmers. And he's going to play with it. 2-1-1 Gloucester. Short. Oh, he's short it wide. E.J. Field. Costanzo had Field, and he missed the open net. That was a short-handed attempt for the Fishermen. They got to get back. Here comes Lynn on the power play still. Lyons hustles after it. And what do we got? Offsides. Offsides on Gloucester, I guess. Unless Lyons went over the blue line and the puck was still on the other side. I think that's what happened. Yeah, I couldn't see it from this angle. All right. All right. 17 seconds left on the Lynn power play. Gloucester has had the better of the chances, and the defenseman falls down. Lyons has the puck. Nice pass out to Sperry. Shot is blocked. And here comes Lynn. They got 4 seconds left on the power play. A shot. Shot goes wide. Good chance there for Lynn. Hopkins. And here comes Lynn. They throw it in. The Lynn Jets. Hopkins. Mitchell flips it. Oh, good hit there. Liam Lyons. Oh, nice hit. And do we have a penalty on that? Or do we have an injured player? Yeah, number 14 was on the receiving end on that hit by Liam Lyons. No penalty. Mike Clarity, he has a goal tonight for Lynn. And he just got tattooed by Liam Lyons. No penalty. That was a clean hit. Faceoff will be in the neutral zone. 3.5 minutes left, second period. Fields, Costanzo, and Brennan are back out there on the draw. Brennan puts it in the zone. Puck comes outside the zone. Harrison Marshall with it. He throws it in deep. But Lynn comes out with it. Broken up by Gloucester again. Here comes Lynn. 3-on-2. Shot. Save. Polinski. Kept in by the Jets. And here comes Eric Chalmers again. Chalmers gets it out front. Tied up by Jack Stafford, the Lynn goaltender. A big matchup here, Gloucester versus Lynn, Northeast Conference South game. Both teams need a win badly. 2:54 left, second period. First line back out there. Costanzo Field. And this time, Chris Noyes is out there with the first line. Shot, deflected, Field, shot, wide. Kept in by Polinski. No, he can't keep it in. And here comes Lynn, 3-on-1. Chris Noyes hustles back. Puck goes to the near corner. Puck goes behind the net. Polinski, Costanzo takes it. Here comes Sal. Good speed. Gains the blue line, tries to make a move, but he can't. Field behind the net, but Lynn takes over. Chris Noyes is out there. Noyes over to Costanzo. He's got Field out front, shot, save, Stafford! A beauty! He stuck the leg out there. What a save by Stafford. Here come the Fishermen now. E.J. Field again. He's got Lyons with him. Shot high. Lyons throws it over to the far side. Sperry keeps it in. It goes behind the net. Gloucester's getting a line change. And there's no question Gloucester's had the better opportunities in this second period. Colby Mitchell over to Sperry. Back to Polinski. And Lynn locks it back in. They're on a line change now. Lyons makes a nice pass to Hopkins. He gets tripped in the game. Yeah, he's going out for that. All right, so the Fishermen will go on a power play with 1:18 remaining in the second period. Number 18 for Lynn. Tripping. Brian Clarity. All right. 1:18 left, second period. Gloucester's on a power play, and they've had several scoring opportunities in this period. Puck just won't go in the net. Costanzo on the draw. He wins the faceoff. Chalmers with it. Lyons to Costanzo. Shot. Oh, quick whistle there. The puck came loose. Stafford made the original save. But the referee blew the whistle so quick it wasn't funny. .124 left on the Gloucester power play. .112 left on the period. Off the draw, they win it again. Polinski with it. Oh, they try to get it back. Oh, they keep it in. Chalmers keeps it in. He's in good shot. Oh, blocked. It got deflected wide. 1 minute left in the period, and we got another penalty coming up on Lynn. Gloucester will have a two-man advantage. Cross check, number two, Sean Devon. So the Fishermen will have a two-man advantage for the last 55 seconds of this period. So what an opportunity for Gloucester here. And if there's no scoring in the 55 seconds, the Fishermen will take that into the third period. Chalmers with it. Polinski keeps it in. It goes down low. Lyons in there. Out front. Polinski. Costanzo with it. Over the. Costanzo. Back up high. Chavez with a nice move. Costanzo with it. He's in the middle. Shot. Blocked. And Lynn clears it. 20 seconds left in the period. A two-man advantage for the Gloucester Fishermen here. And one more trip up the ice. They better hurry up or the period's out. Nice pass there. Here comes Costanzo. Out to Polinski. Shot is blocked. 3 seconds shot. Save. Rebound. Shot. It went in the net. Did they count the goal? Right at the buzzer, they're saying no. They're saying no. Oh, my God. The Fishermen even scored a goal in this period, and it doesn't count. The referees are discussing it, but the teams are leaving the ice.
Shot. Shot. Shot.
All right. We'll be back for third period action in a few moments.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Glover's Floor Covering, for more than 60 years, we have provided our customers with real value in quality carpets, hardwood flooring, laminate flooring, vinyl flooring, and ceramic tile. We're involved in the communities we serve and take great pride in our ability to support Cape Ann Television, so that they in turn can deliver valuable community-based programming for Cape Ann.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support Cape Ann TV. Volunteer production opportunities are available in all the towns we serve. Get into local TV. Call the station to find out more.
We are a full-service florist. We deliver to all of Cape Ann and the North Shore. We also provide wedding flowers, funeral flowers, everything from birth to death, basically. My name is Maria Russell, and I own and work at Russell's Florist in Gloucester. We have been in business in Gloucester for 21 years. We were both born and raised here. Our parents were also born and raised here. Our grandparents were born and raised here, so it seemed a good fit for us. I think it's important to support KPN-TV because it provides so much for our community. There's so much programming on there, and usually at any given time you turn the TV on, KPN-TV, you'll see somebody you know or recognize something or some event or some musician, all kinds of things. I think that KPN-TV has so much to offer our community, whether you're in retail, whether you're in the arts, or whether you own a store on Main Street, KPN-TV provides so much for Gloucester and KPN. We are a very proud supporter of KPN-TV.
To learn more about becoming a KPN-TV underwriter, email sponsor at kpntv.org.
All right, everybody, welcome back. Third period action. Jim Capello on the camera tonight. I'm Phil DeCastro, KPN-TV's coverage of Gloucester High School hockey. Score tied at 3. The Fishermen will start the third period with a 2-man advantage, but for only 12 seconds. The other penalty has 36 seconds left on it. So Gloucester has an opportunity here with the power play to start the third. But that period, the second period, was a good period for Gloucester. Even though they didn't score, they had several opportunities. They did score towards the end of the period at the buzzer, but the referee said the buzzer went off before the puck was in the net. And I do have to agree with the ref's decision. So, a very important period coming up for Gloucester here. They get a 2-man advantage for starters. Costanzo will be out there. Chalmers, Sam Polinski, Colby Mitchell. And it looks like Liam Lyons. Yep, that's Liam. With the hit of the year in the second period. And a very, very important period coming up for Gloucester right now. All right. 2-man advantage to start the third. We're almost underway. Off the draw, Gloucester wins it. Chalmers with it. Over to Sam Polinski. Back over to Chalmers. Chalmers has it. Lyons gets it over to Costanzo. One man is back for Lynn, but the Fishermen still on the power play. Shot. Save Stafford. He saw that one all the way from Chalmers. 16 seconds remaining on the Gloucester power play. The faceoff in the Lynn zone. Off the draw. Costanzo wins it again. Lyons out front to Costanzo. Shot, save, Stafford. And Lynn clears it. And that will do it on the power play. We'll go back to 5-on-5 in 1 second. And that's an ice. So Lynn will have the faceoff in Gloucester's zone. So Costanzo remains out there. Chris Noyes is out there with E.J. Field. Off the draw. Lynn wins it. It goes in the corner. Costanzo there. Puck goes along the near boards. Kept in by Lynn. Save Polinski. So the sides are back at full strength. Off the draw, Costanzo. He wins it over to Sperry. Nice job by Costanzo. Field, Meniz has it, and he gets it out of the zone. Here comes Sal Costanzo. He's got the speed. He gets broken up. Offsides, Gloucester. They touch up. EJ Field goes back in on the forecheck. Here comes Lynn. They throw it in, and that's going to be an ice. Boy, this referee is given no leeway on that red line. I mean, even if you got 2 inches on the other side, he's going to call the ice. That Lynn player was about 2 or 3 inches from the red line, and they still called the ice. But the rules are the rules. Lions wins the faceoff. Mitchell throws it in to Hopkins. Hopkins gets it out to Chalmers. Chalmers over to the other side to Marshall. Mitchell along the boards with Lions. Lions is over there. And here comes Lynn. They get it out, but Hopkins has it. Marshall knocks it back in. Chalmers. Shot in, save. Marshall with it. Over to Eric Chalmers. Out front, look out. Save, Polinski. Chalmers lost his stick, it's at center ice. And Lynn keeps it in. Shot from the point, deflected. And Noah Polinski ties it up. A little bit of a nervous time there for the fishermen. Costanzo's out there. Chris Noyes and EJ Field. Noah Polinski's not quite ready yet. There he is. Okay, he's all set now. 12 and a half minutes left in the game. Score tied at 3. Shot, save, rebound. Save, Polinski! What a beauty on the rebound. Wow. Whew, baby, what goaltender was seen in this game tonight? Jack Stafford and Noah Polinski. Shot goes wide. Shot again, deflected, goes wide. Lynn putting on some pressure now. Shot goes wide. It's the Lynn Jets putting on some heat now. They keep it in. Takes it to the middle. Shot, save, Polinski. His brother clears out the other player. Sam Polinski with it, banks it off the boards, and they finally get it out. EJ Field with it, finds Costanzo with a nice pass. Sal turns the corner, takes a hit, stays on his feet. Marshall Harrison trying to get it in, but he can't, has control of the puck, gives it over to Eric Chalmers. Here comes Mitchell, he's got Lions. And tied up by Stafford. Jack Stafford and Noah Polinski are putting on a goaltending show here tonight. Lions on the draw. It's got Hopkins and Mitchell out there with them. Chalmers and Marshall on the other defense. Marshall has it. Shot in, save. Derek Hopkins in the corner, gets it back up high to the point. Shot by Harrison Marshall, deflected wide. Colby Mitchell. Can't keep it in. And here comes Lynn. Look out. Puck was bouncing Lynn's way there. They almost broke in all alone, but the fishermen get it out of there. No, Lynn keeps it in. Mitchell makes a nice pass. Oh, Hopkins had Liam Lyons going in all alone, but Lyons has it over to Hopkins. Save, rebound, kicking it in. It's out front. They can't knock it home. Shot wide by Mitchell. And the fishermen have been shot by Chalmers. Deflected, rebound. And the net come off its moorings. And Gloucester is just all over the place in the offensive zone, but the puck just won't go in the net. 10:34 left, third period. Costanzo off the draw. Chris Noyes, he has it along the boards. Sperry, shot, save. Stafford. Gloucester trying to keep it in. They do. Puck goes in. Field. Costanzo, he's looking for Noyes. Can't find him. Sperry, shot. It's fans on. Here comes Lynn with a 2-on-1. Fisherman going to get back. They do a good job. Nice pass. And we have a whistle behind the play. The net again come loose. Shots on goal at 21-21. The score is tied at 3-3. And the statistics on the scoreboard indicate these two teams as evenly matched teams, I think. Puck goes in on goal. Harrison Marshall with it. Over to Eric Chalmers. Lyons. Takes it over the blue line. Shot. Save again by Stafford. And his own player knocked it back to him. And he had to make another save. Puck goes behind the Lynn net. Fishman on a line change. Back to Chalmers. Shot blocked. It bounces in and Lynn gains control. And here comes Lynn. 3-on-2. No. Save Polinski. Marshall with it. Back over to Chalmers.
Take off.
And he flips it out. Lyons. Got Hopkins with them. Liam Lyons. And he's tripped. And we're going to have a penalty on Lynn. And the player for Lynn, who's going out? Number 11, I believe. Yeah, number 11. Steve Patry is going out for Lynn for a trip. So the fishermen will go on the power play with 8:52 left, third period. Costanzo. On the faceoff, Mitchell, Lyons, Chalmers, and Polinski is the line. Off the draw, fishermen win it. They get it back to Polinski. Throws it back down to Lyons. Back over to Polinski. Back down to Lyons. Lyons maintains possession. Chalmers back to Polinski. Back down to Lyons out front. Shot. Sell, save again by Stafford. Colby Mitchell had another chance. Mitchell again after it, save Stafford. And the fishermen have had excellent zone time basically from this halfway through the second period on to about this point. But they just can't dent the armor of Jack Stafford. All six goals in this game came in the first period. Puck is cleared by Lynn. Chalmers. Looking to set the play up. Lyons. Looking for Costanzo. Finds him. Oh, no one was there. Mitchell out front to Lyons. Gets it out front, but they can't get it out. Lynn has control, and they clear it. Still a half a minute for the fishermen to do something. Chalmers over to Sam Polinski. Back to Costanzo behind his own net. 20 seconds left on the power play. And here come the fishermen. And Chalmers was yanked down. And there's only 8 seconds left on the power play for Gloucester. Polinski has it behind his own net. Costanzo coming in. Look for Lyons. Couldn't find him. Behind the net. Power play's over. Back out to Sperry. Shot. Blocked. Chalmers. Shot. Oh, that was high. Almost headhunted that one. Shot. Save again. Lyons with the puck. And Sperry can't keep it in. We have an icing on Lynn. And Gloucester has had serious zone time in this period, but they can't seem to get the go-ahead goal. Chris Noyes will take this face-off. He's out there with John Mondello and Lucas Cornetta. Puck comes to the near boards. Mondello. And Lynn gets it out. Good play, Beniz. Shot, save. Nice defensive play by Beniz. And here comes Lynn to get it out of the zone. 2-1-2. Sperry. Out front, look out. Cornetta was there to save the day. And they can't, now they get it out. Lynn keeps in, oh boy. Here comes Cornetta. Fisherman change up lines. Pass up. Another good hit. By Marshall Harrison. Offside Gloucester. They got to touch up. They do. Costanzo plays it back to Chalmers. 5.5 minutes left in the game. And here comes Sal Costanzo. Gets broken up. Timmy White is out there for Gloucester, number 13. Puck is to the near side. Down low, look out. Man out front, shot wide. Lynn has control. And here come the fishermen now. EJ Field, number 3. Trying to make a move, but he can't. He gets broken up. Timmy White fighting for it. Broken up. Oh, Liam Lyons got broken up by the referee. That was an accident, but what are you going to do? Lyons now has it again. Look out. Watch out. Shot. Save Polinski. And the fishermen got to be careful in front of their own net. 4:38 left in the game. Another entertaining high school hockey game here tonight. Liam Lyons on the draw. He wins it. The Sperry up to the near boards. Kobe Mitchell is there, number 16. Sperry with it. Makes a good pass. The Hopkins, but Hobson plays it back. Polinski with a pass in the middle, but can't connect. And Polinski throws a nice hit. Sperry up to Mitchell. Back down low again. Polinski has it. Hopkins. Back over to Polinski. Back up to Hopkins. Fishman trying to get it out. Mitchell. Pass it to Liam Lyons, but they couldn't connect. Hopkins gets it in the Lynn zone. 3:50 remaining in the game. And it was not kept in. Offsides, Gloucester. Eric Chalmers tried to keep it in, but he couldn't. Costanzo, Noyes, and Field are the forwards. Chalmers and Harrison are the two defensemen out there right now with 3:40 left in the game. Off the draw. Puck goes in the Gloucester end. Sal Costanzo hustles after it. It comes to the near corner. Chalmers, Marshall, but Lynn has control.
Get the puck.
Chris Noyes over to Marshall. Marshall knocks it up the field, but Lynn knocks it back in. That was offsides. Chalmers has it, but he can't control it, and Lynn gets it back down in the corner. They got a man out front. Look out. And Chris Noyes skates away with it. Nice play by Noyes. He shoots it wide. E.J. Field goes down in there. Noyes on the forecheck, but the puck comes to the near boards. Chalmers shoots it in. 2:40 remaining in the game. All the goals in this game. Nice play by Chalmers, but he can't keep the puck in. Nice hit there. Field over to Chalmers. Shot wide. Sperry keeps it in. Eric Chalmers again comes down and can't keep it in. The Lynn player loses his stick, and that helped out Liam Lyons. Shot save Stafford. 2:09 left in the game with a 3-3 tie, and all the goals in this game have been scored in the first period. Since then, we've had several scoring opportunities, especially by the fishermen, but the puck just hasn't gone in the net. All right, Liam Lyons on the draw. Wins the faceoff, back to Sperry. Sperry shot, blocked. Colby Mitchell. Puck goes in behind the net. Polinski tries to crack down, he does. Out front, oh! Lyons was right there. Lyons shot. Save Stafford. Nice hustle there by Hopkins. Hopkins doing good in the corners. Mitchell out front. Shot. Oh, Lyons shoots it wide. Another golden opportunity for Gloucester. Stafford keeps it in. Sperry. I'm sorry. That was Sperry. Off the boards. Colby Mitchell with a nice play. 1.5 minutes left in the game. Fishman better be careful with the puck. And Lynn has control. And they shoot it in. Goes in deep. Sperry with it. Jack Sperry, number 11. Over to the far boards. Oh, what a hit. But Costanzo hustles after it. Out front to Noyes. The puck is loose. And the net comes loose as well. And Christopher Noyes takes a hit. And we're under a minute now. 56 seconds remaining. 3-3 tie. After the game, I'm going to try to get in touch with Eric Chalmers, number 21 for Gloucester. He's had a fine game tonight for the Fisher. We have a timeout. We'll keep it right here. Shots on goal at 24-22 Gloucester. And the way this game is being played, two evenly matched teams, no question. And Lynn, they had a 3-1 lead halfway through the first period. Gloucester fought back to tie it. So I believe that was a Gloucester timeout. Yep. 56 seconds remaining. And the Fishermen, if they get the tie here today, they'd be 0-1-1 in the conference. And they only have 1 point. Overall, they'll go to 4-6-1. That will give them 9 points on the year. And if they can come away with the victory here tonight, it'll be big for their confidence for the rest of this season. They have the faceoff in Lynn's zone. Gasel Costanzo's out there with Field, Lyons, Chalmers, and Polinski. And this time Lynn wins it. Kept in by Polinski, but Lynn gets it out. No, Polinski does a great job to keep it in. And they can't control it. Lynn has it. 45 seconds left in the game. And Lynn clears it. Chalmers has it. 40 seconds left. Polinski back over to Chalmers. Half a minute left. Costanzo doesn't see the puck. Lyons. Oh, back over to Chalmers. And the Fishermen can't get in the zone. They're running out of time. They're looking for Sal Costanzo up the middle. They can't find him. Lynn's all over him. And 9 seconds. Costanzo. 4 seconds. Can't get it out front. That's going to do it, folks. We're going to have a 3-3 tie. And what was a very entertaining game here tonight. And I'm going to head down on ice level and talk to Eric Chalmers.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
When you walk into either of our branches, you will experience a local bank feel with big bank returns. We are proud to support many community organizations, nonprofits, and events, both financially and by employees volunteering their time. That's why we support KPN Television, so that with the help of their volunteers, they can deliver valuable community-based news, sports, and information about KPN, which is so important to us all.
Join, volunteer, support. Local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPAN TV. You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Scott Energy, we have built our business one customer at a time with a hands-on, personal approach. In the process, we have gained customers in our communities who have come to appreciate our attention to value and quality service. We truly appreciate your business, and in turn, have made it our policy to give back to the communities that we serve. That's why we support KPN Television, so that they can deliver valuable, community-based news and information about KPN, which is important to all of us.
Join, volunteer, support. Local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPAN TV.
I'm here with KPN TV's player of the game, Eric Chalmers. And Eric, you guys dominated the second and third period, but you just couldn't find the back of the net.
Yeah, you know, it's a good goalie. It's hard to put the puck in the net against him, so you got to get bodies in front. Yeah. And I thought we did better job as the game went on with that. So.
Yeah. First period, kind of a helter-skelter game. You guys fought back. You got the tying goal. Yeah. No goals were scored the rest of the game, but I thought you guys had the edge in play. Yeah, some bad luck. You hit the couple of the posts. But you guys are up against it now the rest of the season. Need some wins.
Yep, we do. Got to come back again. So I think Swampscott on Wednesday.
That's Salem State, yeah. Okay. All right, Eric, congratulations. You're having a great season. Keep it up. And good luck the rest of the year.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. Well, that will wrap it up for tonight. It's KPN TV's coverage of Gloucester High School Hockey. Until next time, good night, everybody.